Hello my people, welcome back to this channel. This is your one and only favorite mom, Mama D Super. How you guys doing? Hope you guys are doing fantastically well. As for me, I am doing great. Thank you all for coming back to my old returnees. God bless you. To the new ones, I say God bless you. To the ones that are about to subscribe right now, I say God bless you. To those of you that always share my videos, that always hang out with me, that even watch me from afar, in fact, God bless you, bless you, bless you. Today, let's talk about Thanksgiving. We call it Saraka in Nigeria, where I come from. You understand? Today, we are going to dig it. The meaning of Thanksgiving. The reason why we give and we are not blessed, and we are still where we are, complaining day in, day out. And the reason why we should give alms, because it's very, very important. It's not only by going to the church to pay your tithe, to pay your offering, to pay your first fruit offering, empty your bank account in January. No. Those are giving on their own terms. But today I'm talking about almsgiving, which is very, very, very important. Very important to us as a community, because that's what we are failing to do. Because most of us, we do sup for sup, as in YT. I give to Mama D, Mama D give me. That's why we are still where we are. We are not activating that God's principle of giving, because God did not say He will only bless the Christians. It's a principle. You see, most of the time, even the unbelievers, people that doesn't go to church, let me use that, permit me to use the word, they are even the ones that are more blessed, because they are givers. They give with all their hearts, not expecting anything from you. Until we start giving like that in our community, we will remain where we are, year in, year out, which is not good. That is why I brought our attention to it. I'm talking to you, I'm talking to myself. We should stop giving and expecting. By so doing, we will gain nothing. Because when you give to me, definitely, I will try and give to you tomorrow. Even if I don't have today, I don't have tomorrow. Maybe by next week or 1 year, I will always remember that, so and so did good for me or gave me something like this. I must try and pay you back. That is humor for you. We can't change it. For me, I only give to people that are closer to me when I'm led. That's how it should be. You should be led to give to people that have already. And don't also say, when you are being led by the Spirit, you have to have a designing spirit. Designment is the number one principle. Because when you don't have a designing spirit, you don't know who is who. You don't know who you are going to give, because that is another major problem in our community. When you see some people, beggars are begging, oh, auntie, I've not eaten since morning, give me money. Even in Africa, even here in the diaspora, you see a lot of us, we are critics. You say, even people that are working with you, maybe your friends or even family, will tell you, are you going to give your money to this beggar? No, I don't give my money. I don't want them to use my money for ritual. I don't want anybody to take my loco. I don't want anybody to take my style. I don't want anybody. Witches and wizards, they are everywhere. Yes, we know. But that is the reason why you should have the spirit of discernment. And also, before you give your money out, you should pray about it. Pray and give it to people. Even when you are passing through problem or you are not passing through problem, anoint yourself with the money and give it. If you are so particular that they are wishes and wizards that they are going to use your star, you understand? Because those people, you don't even know them. And most of the time, it turns out that the people that you don't know that you are giving to, they are the one even blessing you. They are the one praying for you, because somebody that have not eaten since morning, peradventure 2 days time, the person is even thinking of, what am I going to do? Some people even go to the extent of, I don't need to, deleting themselves. You understand? Then such a one now find an opportunity, being blessed by you. You think that person will take your money to the coven or where? He will pray for you. Such a person will pray for you, but so unfortunate that the community where we are coming from, all we know best to do is to especially people that are poor, that are looking tattered. You know, when you have been in poverty for so long, you'll be labeled a witch or a wizard, or the name that your parents didn't give to you will now become your second name. You understand? So that's the reason why we should have a designing spirit, to be able to know who is who, to be able to know that, okay, and be led, let me give it to this person. And also, don't forget beggars in the street, even in the diaspora. Yes, I said earlier, you see some people, when they want to give, they say, ah, these people, they are drug addicts. Oh, no, if I give my money to them, they will go and use it to do drugs. No, I can never give it to them. I'm not helping them by giving them. It's true, you are right, but is it only money you give to people? No, those type of people, maybe they are hungry. You can also buy food stuff and give to them. If you see they are looking tattered, some of them, you can buy them jackets, you can buy them clothes, you can, in fact, you can do a lot of things to help people. Let's be our brother's keepers. And even if you are led to give to me, you can also give to your family and friends when you are led by the Spirit, because you don't know at that particular time what they are passing through. God, Holy Spirit might be laying it in your heart as I'm speaking to you now, that bless Mama D. But because you are so stubborn, you thinking, no, that woman, no, why will I go and bless her? Is she not working? She have enough. Sometimes people will even say, why will I bless such a one? She even have more than me. No. When it's the Spirit that is calling for it, when you are being led by the Spirit and you didn't delay in doing it, there's a blessing behind it. There's a blessing attached to it, because for you obeying the voice at all, there's a blessing for it. And don't forget, always bless people that cannot pay you back. Give to people that cannot pay you back. There are a lot of people in Nigeria, leprosy people. You think when you bless such people, they will take your money to the coven or take your clothes? No. Even if you don't want to give them money, buy foodstuff, buy clothes. There are a lot of things to buy, to give to them. They will pray for you. You will see, when you start doing all these things, you will be moving forward. Your life will never remain the same anymore. You will never be stagnant anymore. You will be surprised. Anything you lay your hands to do, the way it will be, just be moving. You will just be moving for you. Let me use that word, magic. But it is not magic. Because of this principle of giving that you have begin to follow, you see the way blessing of God and mercy of God will begin to shower blessings upon you and your household. You understand? So these are the principles of giving. By number one, give to people that can never pay you back. Don't give to people that will pay you back tomorrow or next tomorrow. No, give to people that can never pay you back, so God will be the one to reward you. Understand? Okay, and before I leave, also, when you are embarking on a spiritual journey, maybe you did a fast for many days, or you did a spiritual cleansing, don't let it go like that, because you can, don't go empty-handed to God. You understand? Always back it up with giving. Look for people to always give things to. People that can never pay you back. You can just buy food stuff, buy things, go visit the motherless home, orphanages, even schools, go to the street, the beggars, just share things for them with your heart, free will. Like that, God will bless you, because as God is blessing you, because God is pleased with your work, men also are pleased with your work, because people that you gave it to, whether they are deaf and dumb, they have a way of blessing you. They have a way of praying for you, because I'm hungry and you fed me. You think I will abuse you? No. I will pray for you. And the prayer, because it came from my womb, it came from my innermost being, it will bless you. It will really touch you. So these are the things, these are the principles that we don't have to ignore in our life if we want our life to move forward. If we don't want to be stagnant in life, we don't want to remain in a place January to December, these are the things that we have to follow. We have to make it a principle in our life. Thank you so much for listening and watching me. I really appreciate you all. Thank you so much. God bless you. If you have not yet subscribed, don't forget to subscribe. If you have done so, please share me out to your friends and relatives. Give this video a thumbs up if you find it helpful and interesting. Until I come your way next time, I remain your humble Mama D Super. Thank Thank you so much, guys. I love you, but don't forget Jesus.